Monday, so I'm kegging and bottling my American Rye Stout today, and also just dry hopping a Cooper's Kit that I have on as well, so you'll see a clip of that now.
Right, in here I have 25 grams of Columbus and 25 grams of Cascade. Just getting ready now to throw it into the fermenter, so here we go. Made a hop tea to start with, I threw that in as well, just to make sure I got all the hops out of it. Then I'll let it sit for another week. And this one here, the American Rye Stout, that's going to get kegged and bottled now in a minute.
I've got, it's just a salmon there. Just salmon there dry hopping. Now I have my keg, as we see here.
Cleaned, sterilized, ready to go. The white bit of wire just tells me what side is the gas post when it's in the fridge, because it's not much room in there to see. It's quite handy. Also, I had some beer. Yeah, I got myself a new pop spider.
See, it came a bit dented. It was a lot flatter than this when I got it, but I did my best to get it into some kind of round shape. So that'll get a run in the next brew. I've seen quite a few people on Facebook getting these, and they're flat as a pancake. Well, not bad for 15 quid. So we'll see how that goes. I'm gonna give it a try. Just planning my next brew. Don't know whether to do my Rust Bucket clone at Kinnegar, the local brewery here in Donegal. Thinking of doing that next, or I might have a go at a pale ale. Maybe, I'm not sure yet. I'll have to see what I decide on the day. And as you see, I have my keg ready. Just got my bottles ready now. Where all starts at. Ready to go. Just gonna put some primary sugar in them and we can start racking off from the fermenter.
Right, that's the bottles primed, ready for the stout. So just get the signing pipe and bottling wand out of the star sand. Now, I've already cleaned the tap with some star sand, so just keep that on there. Not easy when you're on the camera. Right, that's the tap cleaned and a bit run through, so you don't get no yeast into the keg. So we'll open the tap and let it rip. Let's just tilt it over. Splash too much. That's better. Right, we'll just let that fill up. Cover it over. Yeah, she's still gonna splash. Should be alright now. And keep an eye on it. You see, you've got the bottles ready again. I'm Let's have a little smell of this. Let's have a look about that. Smells fruity. That's not bad. Tastes very good. I'm going to shift that from there. Right, let's see how I'm getting on. Yeah, we're filling up. Yeah, I have the caps ready in here. Should be enough in there. Yeah, my capper. Screwed down to the bench. Should be ready at the bottom now in a minute. And as you can see, I've the keg now filled. And putting the rest in the bottles. That's it up there. And I'll stick a cap on it to keep any flies out. Right. That's 14 bottles and a keg filled. Keg's on the gas and burped. So it's carbon up now, so that'll probably be on gas now for a couple of weeks. Or a week at least. So that's bottling day done and kegging done. That's another video done for this week. So I'll see you soon. Cheers, bye.